I saw another angel. This one was flying across the sky and had the eternal good news to announce to the people of every race, tribe, language, and nation on earth. The angel shouted, "Worship and honor God. The time has come for Him to judge everyone. Kneel down before the one who created heaven and earth, the oceans, and every stream." A second angel followed and said, "The great city of Babylon has fallen. This is the city that made all nations drunk and immoral. Now God is angry, and Babylon has fallen." Finally, a third angel came and shouted, "Here is what will happen if you worship the beast and the idol and have the mark of the beast on your hand or forehead. You will have to drink the wine that God gives to everyone who makes Him angry. You will feel His mighty anger, and you will be tortured with fire and burning sulfur. While the holy angels and the Lamb look on, if you worship the beast and the idol and accept the mark of its name, you will be tortured day and night. The smoke from your torture will go up forever and ever, and you will never be able to rest. God's people must learn to endure. They must also obey His commands and have faith in Jesus." Those words come from Revelation 14, verses 6 to 12. There is a song with the lines, "Just keep on walking. You don't know how far you've come. For all you know, the Father might be standing up right now to give the call and end it all. Just keep on walking." Don't spend all your time and energy trying to fit the pieces of the end times puzzle together. Are the end times upon us? Well, my opinion is that they most certainly are. But what am I to do about it? My response to the knowledge that the end times are here is that I must strengthen my relationship with Jesus Christ and walk daily with Him. I will be ready for whatever comes my way if Jesus is by my side. It is not important that I know everything that will happen, but it is critical that I am at the side of Jesus when it does. So when you see a piece of the puzzle clearly before your eyes, let that be an opportunity for you to draw ever closer to Jesus Christ. Keep Jesus in the front of your mind all day long. Pray literally without ceasing as you see sign after sign unfold on the horizon of your day. Let your response to what you see be endurance, obedience, and faith. Lord Jesus, the world around us is teeming with what appear to be fulfilled prophecies about your return. Hold me tight in your arms as I wait for the sound of the final trumpet and meet you in the air. And may you be praised now and forever. Amen.